Hey, welcome back to my channel. So we're just jumping right in today, right in it, okay? Natural hair. So here's a picture of my hair dripping wet, well, pretty much wet with conditioner. And then here is my hair towel dried. I am going to list all the products I use to wash my hair as well as these products down below. So first I use the Afro G Keratin Green Tea Reconstructor. I love this stuff. I just always put this on my hair first, no matter what I'm doing with my hair. I really think it helps protect my hair and keep it strong. Then I love the It's a 10 Leave-In. Y'all, this is just a classic. Like, if you have never tried the It's a 10 Leave-In product spray, I mean, like, what are you doing? Like, no. Seriously, it's the OG. So I'm using quite a bit of products. One, I want my hair to be moisturized before I straighten it. And then I also want it to be super protected before I'm putting the heat on my hair. Now, I tend to blow dry my hair 98% of the time, 99% really, after I wash it. So my hair is used to being blow dried. So I'm also using the Melanin Leave-In Conditioner. This stuff is amazing. I'm only using a little bit of this. So although I am using quite a bit of products, I'm only using a specific amount for each specific type of product on purpose, depending on what the product does and how I'm layering the products, and all this is on purpose for my specific hair. Everybody's hair is different. Yes, that melanin stuff smells good, but everybody's hair is different. So just kind of test out different products and see what your hair likes. So here I'm using the Chi Total Protectant Heat Protectant Lotion. Okay. The name's gonna be below, y'all, okay? But I like this as well. I'm focusing this more on the ends and then putting it around the perimeter of my hair, as you see. I also will be following up with two other heat protectants. Y'all, I don't play. This is not a game. I'm not necessarily, quote unquote, like, scared of heat or anything, but yeah, natural hair be like, natural girls be like, always trying to pull the hair. Then I'm using the Chi Iron Guard Heat Protectant Spray. Again, just layering on those heat protectants. Some I'm using more than others, etc., all that good stuff. But I really just love Chi products. I really think they're great for protecting our tresses, our queen crowns, all that stuff. I just love the products. They're tried and true for me. Here is the next day. I actually just didn't feel like doing nothing after I washed my hair. We're fist fighting in the shower, okay? So here's my hair. I just dampened it a little bit. Pro tip for me and my hair, again, everybody's hair is different. You have to just try out different methods and see what your hair likes. So I like to blow dry my hair when it's pretty damp. It's not dripping soaking wet. It is dripping a little bit, okay? But it's not like soaking wet, but it is damp because overnight, of course, my hair dried quite a bit. So I went ahead and sprayed it again, and I will leave the link to the spray bottle that I use. It's the Continuous Spray. It's amazing. I should have actually recorded because it's that phenomenal. I've been using this OG, I'm telling you, this Revlon 1 and 2 in 1, whatever it is, okay? This is the GOAT. If you see my other blowout video, you know I love this, and as you saw, it is used. I need to buy another one because it is that good. It's that amazing. But yeah, the only thing about it is it does blow air only at the top of it, so just keep that in mind while you're blow drying. So with the since I did dampen my hair, I went ahead and followed up again with the Iron Guard spray. But when I straighten my hair, I'm going to use the Chi Silk Infusion, and that's just, you just have to use it, like, you just should use it if you're going to straighten your hair. But I'm just going in again with the Iron Guard spray, not being scared to use it, y'all. Don't be scared of the sprays, okay? My hair is thick. So I just separated my hair into three quadrants, three sections. So I have one in the back and then two in the front. So y'all, hair brush is dirty too. Don't play with me. So I'm brushing starting at the ends and then working my way up to the roots. I like using a paddle brush. My hair likes it. It works. Bada bing, bada boom, okay? And then I'm just going to make sure that is completely detangled before I go in with the Revlon blow dryer brush. And you will see I angle it towards, like, going frontwards because that air is coming out right in that, like, front part of the brush. So you see I'm kind of angling it down to make sure that I'm getting the heat distributed throughout that section. So I actually should have towel dried my hair just a little bit more, which is why it's taking me a little bit longer to blow dry that section. Usually, once y'all will see, once we get going, we're going to go through this pretty quickly. This is not a long method when it comes to blow drying my hair. I can do this, y'all, less than 30 minutes. Not even that. I can blow dry my hair really quickly with this brush. It's amazing, especially when I have my hair nicely washed, cleaned, using the correct products, completely detangled, and then I go in and blow dry. It's such an easy process. So y'all know how it is when you see your hair length. And, wait, I got to do it. I had to do it. I'm sorry. I had to do it. We love to see. Shrinkage, we love her, but we hate her because I know my hair is healthy when it's shrinking and things like that with my hair type. But yes, we love to see some length, okay? We love to see it. So I'm pretty much going to do the same thing throughout the entire entirety of my head. Again, brushing from the ends to the roots and really just thoroughly detangling it and then following up with the blow dryer. So I won't talk the entire time through this part, but I will be back once we get to flat ironing my hair. Enjoy! Yes. Okay, blowout. The key to the perfect straighten and flat iron silk press is a good blowout, y'all. Okay. So I'm using the Babyliss Pro Nano Ultra Thin Flat Iron. I think that's the full name. I love this. I've had it for y'all. I've had it for so long. I don't even know. Maybe 7 years, maybe more. I have it on 375, and I think I ended up upping it to 400 because my hair can handle it. That's one thing that I think the difference is when we do our hair at home, we're like scared to use heat, but when we go to a hairstylist, they know how to control the heat. They know what heat your hair can handle and stuff like that. So I think that's kind of like why every time I go get my hair actually done by somebody that's a professional, it's always like silky, smooth, perfect. And I'm like, dang, how she do that? But this is, you know, pretty good. And I hadn't straightened my hair myself in a while, so I thought this was pretty good. I definitely intend on doing a follow-up, maybe in like 3 months or so, but I'm not scared of heat, okay? I'm not scared of heat. My hair is okay. It's just hair, y'all. I wear it how I like to, and y'all know 9 times out of 10 I'm wearing a wig anyway, okay? Period. But here is what I'm doing. I use the comb chasing method. As you see, I put the comb on my hair. Of course, I, you know, detangle it a little bit after I put my silk infusion heat protectant on it, as y'all saw. And I put the comb on my hair first, and then I follow it with the straightener, just like this. And I like to hit my roots a few times. I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 times, and then I usually only do 1 pass. I think I might have did 2 passes over, like, 2 sections. Maybe not even that, not even that. 9.9999 times out of 10, I do 1 pass. I just don't need another pass. And another reason I do one pass is because I do like to follow up and curl it. Either I use my straightener to kind of put a little bump, you know, do a little something with it. So I got some little volume, a little something to it. Or I use a wand curler. And if I do straight curl my hair with a straightener, I make sure that I turn that heat down. So I straighten it on 375 to 400. But when I curl it, it's on 350, 300, maybe even, you know, less than that. Just kind of depends. And wand curlers, as y'all know, get pretty hot, but I don't leave it on there that long, okay? You don't want to burn your little hair off, okay? But here I'm just showing you the difference between it blow-dried and straightened. As you see, clearly the straightened flat iron area is much silkier and smoother, but I'm not going to talk y'all ear off. I'm literally doing the same thing, doing the comb chasing method or chasing comb method, or y'all know what y'all say, but yeah. And then I will come back to you guys at the end. Please enjoy. If you're enjoying this content, thumbs it up. Leave me some comments below. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And yeah, I'll get back to you guys at the end. Yes, we love to see it, okay? We really do this for the ponytail, okay? But thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to thumbs up, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff. Share with your family and friends, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Love you guys. Later!